has been interesting. We're going to do a little sidebar. There are entrepreneurs out there who have built brands over decades. They've taken something and over time given it meaning. And they've given it value. There are companies that have chosen to, within the law, make products by the same name or a similar name to the products that these entrepreneurs have built. They may change the spelling slightly. They now stand on the backs of these entrepreneurs, hiding behind the legal aspect of their decision. Just because something is legal does not make it moral. You're about to hear a story involving our next honoree and the late Marvin Glass. A story of how Milton Bradley did what was right and what was moral, even if legally they had no obligation to do so whatsoever. Could something like the story you're about to hear happen today in the industry that we love? This year, for the first time, we recognize the role that inventor relations executives play in our industry by awarding the first ever Tagie Award for excellence in inventor advocacy to Milton Bradley's own Mel Taft. Mel could not be here tonight, but we are thrilled to have someone who has experienced Mel's advocacy firsthand. Reyn Geyer developed and licensed the Twister game to Milton Bradley in 1967. 2 years later, he developed and licensed the Nerf ball to Parker Brothers. He is the co-founder of Reyn Song Music in Nashville, an accomplished songwriter, playwright, and painter. Please welcome Reyn Geyer to the stage.
Thank you, Tim. Thank you all.
I am honored to be asked to do this. Mel Taft was a mentor of mine. He was my mentor in this business. And as such, we knew that we could fight a little bit, and we did. And we knew that in the end, we were not going to embarrass one another or put each other in a position that anybody would resent the outcome. And he and I have been friends for a long, long time. I'm going to tell you a little story about how Mel Taft had an intensity and a vigor, and he would get a hold of something and he wouldn't let go. To wit, after Milton Bradley had decided to come out with Twister, they had developed all of the ads and everything was ready to rock. Mel called me just before Christmas in 1966. And he said, "Reyn, I'm really sorry to say, but we can't do this. It's too out there. Sears has looked at it and they can't do it. And we're gonna have to back off. We're pulling all our spot ads, and I regret that this has to happen." Unbeknownst to anybody else within the confines of the Milton Bradley Company, Mel Taft had already paid a PR company to put, if possible, the Twister game on the Johnny Carson show. So Mel and the PR executive sat in the audience that night. And Ava Gabor was among the attendees, part of the show that night. And Ava enticed Johnny Carson onto the mat, and the rest is history. Mel Taft had the stick-to-itivity to really hang in there and make it work. I'm going to read the speech that he wrote. "Dear Mary and Tim, I feel sincerely honored to be chosen for your Inventor Advocacy Award. And I want to thank you all of you very much. And I'm particularly pleased that your award focuses on working with and supporting inventors.
For my earliest days in Milton Bradley, I recognized the importance of inventors. While management always wanted me to develop new products internally, this is his quote, "Some things never change." It occurred to me very early on that to be successful and to be ahead of the crowd, we had only to rely a great deal on the inventing community. Therefore, I took great care to develop very strong two-way relationships, particularly with inventors I felt had a high potential for success. Many of these relationships turned into very strong professional and personal relationships, which paid big dividends for all of us over the years. Many of you know that I was also always particularly close to Marvin Glass, who in my opinion had a great deal to do with how toy inventing evolved in the real and honorable profession it is today. Let me tell you a little bit story about something that happened to cement my relationship with Marvin. It seems very appropriate for this group tonight. Back in the early 60s, I bought a game from Marvin that had to do with oil drilling. When I got the game back to Springfield and showed it to my gang, they started working with it to develop better gameplay. In the course of doing this, it was my internal group that actually came up with an entirely different idea, which turned out to be the game of Operation. Because the final version of Operation actually came out of our internal group, my president felt we did not owe Marvin any royalty at all, and that we should simply return his original oil drilling game to him immediately. And I refused to do this. When I finally did take the oil game back to Marvin, I did so in person, and I explained to him that while I was returning it, I felt we never would have come up with Operation if we had not started with his idea, and because of that, we would pay him his full royalty. This made such an impression on Marvin that he jumped up and gave me a big bear hug. Marvin was quite short. Mel was quite tall. That would have been an interesting hug. Gave me a big bear hug, along with the comment, "Taft, you are a very unusual guy." I'm not telling you this story just to pat myself on the back. As many of you have heard me say many times over the years, I firmly believe new ideas are the lifeblood of our industry. All of you as members of the professional inventing community are a critical source of those ideas. Those of us who have been lucky enough over the years to manage a successful toy company, and those who still do, know that we can never relax and take it for granted that the next great new idea will just fall into our lap. Nor do they come about because we toy executives are so brilliant. They actually come to the management teams that respect and pay attention to the inventing community. The reason I wanted to tell you the Operation story tonight is because I think it illustrates why we were able to get so many great ideas from inventors of Milton Bradley year after year. I made it a cornerstone of my entire career, both at Milton Bradley and afterwards with Mel Taft and Associates, to support inventors and do the right thing by them. Part of the reason for this was certainly professional. I wanted them to come to me first. But another big part of it was because of these very strong professional and personal connections that I had to many inventors. They were my friends, and many of them still are.
That is why this award you are giving me tonight means so much to me. New ideas from inventors may be the lifeblood of our industry, but that only works because of relationships like these. My message to the younger inventors in the room tonight is a simple one. If you take the time to build these relationships, you will never regret it. Thank you again for thinking of me and honoring me with this award tonight. And I am only sorry that I could not be here in person to accept it. Mel Taft.
Thank you, Reyn. We sent Mel's award to him. So
I consider it a great honor to have been allowed to do that. He was a great friend and still is.